the triple catastrophe in Japan in 2011 has been called a turning point in a Japanese society. In our session now, we want to discuss changes and obstacles in the development of civil society in Japan. Maybe there are some people, me included, who experienced in 2011 and 2012 the tremendous demonstrations in Tokyo against nuclear power. It was a wave of demonstrations which led to some colleagues to coin this development a second protest cycle in Japanese history after the Second World War. At the same time, new groups and networks of citizens become active, engaged in health and food safety, as well as in support of victims of nuclear catastrophe. Some applying to the MPO status, others not. Some becoming engaged in advocacy activities, others not. These broad movements in Japan have challenged our knowledge concerning Japanese civil society, according to which Japanese civil society is characterized by a majority of small grassroots groups, mostly on the local level, with very low advocacy capacity, low resources, and low degree of institutionalization. And on the other hand, by a minority of well-established advocacy groups and an increasing number of third sector organizations, namely MPOs. Our panel now will explore changes and problems or obstacles in the last 10 years. We have three presentations and we will start with Sato-san. Sato Keiichi-san is an assistant professor at Hitotsubashi Daigaku, and he is from sociology by education. He received his PhD from Hitotsubashi in 2016, and his fields of research are climate change policy and politics, anti-nuclear social movements, social networks, and social analysis. And he will make his presentation on changes in the landscape of anti-nuclear movements after the Fukushima nuclear accident. So I want to hand over to Sato-san. Onegai shimasu.